All right, let's get to Street Meat. Democrats are obsessed with getting some form of health care bill passed. They say they know what's best for us in health care. They think spending $1 trillion of your money will improve your health care. Let's get perspective from a real live medical doctor who disagrees. Dr. Harpat, Dr. P, I'm going to call you Dr. P. We've been on TV all day, last couple of days together, my friend.
Yeah.
You, sir, you and I have gone back and forth. Will a bill, either one of these, the House bill, the Senate bill, or the presidential mashup bill of either of the two, will that help us get better medical treatment?
The way that it's scoped out right now, Eric, nobody's even talking about getting the right treatment. Yesterday in the discussion at the summit, everybody was focused on cost. And you know, for decades, we've been struggling with how to cut cost and how to still keep quality the same. And yesterday, the president kept intertwining two words which are not synonymous, care and coverage.
Thank you.
And it clearly, he made three glaring mistakes yesterday that showed that he didn't understand at the core of why we're trying to reform the system. And that's concerning. That's concerning.
Dr. P, let's take it one step further. Let's give some people some perspective here. Now, there are some good things that can come out of this whole discussion, from the right or from the left. One thing that we both talked about and we agree on, medical records. How can we reform medical records and really save some money?
Medical records are important, and we all agree that there's a lot of chaos in the system right now. There's a lot of information spread out all over the place in terms of how you can get information from your doctors or from the hospitals, and it's very inefficient. So nobody's going to argue that we've got to make an investment. But that's only one small island in terms of information. It's not enough just to connect those two islands. There's a whole host of other information out there that's important. And if we don't pull all that information together, we can't even get to the point that Max Baucus said yesterday about creating the next Travelocity or the next Orbitz or Expedia. Think about all the information that's behind there that drives that. We're not even close or scratch the surface in healthcare to actually get to that point to look at the data. So we've got to do all of that first.
But Dr. P, would it be better for the government to run this medical records, I don't know, clearinghouse, or would it be better for private business to come in and do it?
Private. We can't drive competition amongst the insurance carriers. We've got a system in place. The employers across the country today are the ones that are paying the insurance companies to administer these plans. We don't need the government to come in and hold Anthem or United or Cigna accountable. There's no reason for that. We've got to make the existing system work. And the very fact that they're trying to do that means they don't understand the basics of healthcare 101.
Well, let's talk about the basics of health providing 101. Medicare fraud, waste, and abuse, how big is it really?
It's big. And you know, the numbers that they're talking about in terms of either from a doctor level or in terms of ineligibles or duplicate claims, it's a big number. And we've got to go after that. But that's one component in terms of the overall expenditures that have to be incurred. But how do you go after figuring out where the abuse is? You know, Senator Coburn suggested that we put in these undercover patients, which is one way of going after fraud and abuse. But you got to be pretty well equipped in terms of having the right data to know if doctors are out there overcharging or if hospitals are overcharging. And for that matter, if insurance companies are overcharging.
Doc, what about an honest doctor who's just out there to provide some real good health care? And all of a sudden, take us through the process. If someone's on Medicare or Medicaid, how much does that doctor really get paid on, say, a $1,000 bill he may charge?
It really depends on the specialty, Eric, so it's hard to, you know, to say across the board, because it's going to vary if you're a radiologist or an orthopedic
surgeon.
Give
me a sense. Give me a range.
Or an ophthalmologist. You know, today, if you do cataract surgery on a Medicare patient, you may get paid a few hundred dollars. And, you know, years ago, you would get paid thousands of dollars. So here, you're actually doing something that has immediate results, and you're spending about an hour of your time developing a skill for, you know, decades, and you're getting paid, you know, a few hundred dollars to do that. It doesn't make any sense.
And Doc, that sounds like a lot to people, but in actuality, it could be as little as 7 to 10 or 11 to 12 cents on the dollar. Is that right?
It could be as little as that. That's absolutely right.
All right, Doc, we got to go. We only have about 20 seconds left. Nancy Pelosi claiming 400,000 jobs immediately from a bill. Agree or disagree?
I don't agree with any of her numbers. I think that she's totally off the cuff. Her math is worse than second grade math. And I don't understand the basis of how she comes up with any of her numbers, so totally disagree.
All right, Dr. Sridhar Padarazu, I didn't get it out the first time I got it that time.
You got
Dr.
it
P,
on.
Thanks a lot for joining us.
Thank you for having me on.